Hey guys, so today I'm going to be doing a makeup tutorial for you. This actually feels more like a get ready video though, because I am actually getting ready and I have to leave my house right now. Like, I finished right on time. So yeah, I am sick. I woke up this morning with a terrible sore throat. It hurts so bad. I'm probably gonna have to go to the doctor because it's just not good. And I'm starting to feel like I'm getting a fever too, which is just beyond typical because I am flying this week. I am going to New York City for a half business, half vacation. I will be there for 4 days. I'm leaving on Thursday, return on Monday. So it's like, of course I'm getting sick right now, right? So today is actually Easter Sunday. So I am getting ready. I'm leaving my house soon as I'm done with this to go spend the afternoon with my family for Easter. So yeah, I hope that you guys enjoy this makeup tutorial. It's very spring appropriate. It's very fresh. I absolutely love this look. I've been wearing it constantly recently. This is the same look that I was wearing in my favorites video that I just did. And so many of you were asking what I was wearing and if I could do a tutorial. So here it is. I hope that you guys enjoy. Thanks so much for watching. I love you guys and I'll see you soon. Bye.
Hello, my loves. The first thing we're gonna do today is prime our face. I am using the Makeup Forever Radiant Primer, and I'm just gonna massage this onto my face with clean hands. You know the drill, you know how to prime your skin. Moving on. I'm going to use the Smashbox Primer Water only because I was so dry from being sick, but two primers, not necessary, let's get real. I'm going to also go in with the Kevin Aucoin Liquid Highlighter. I talked about this in my most recent favorites video. This highlighter is my favorite. I'm gonna massage that all over my bare skin just to give a really beautiful radiant glow as the base. Then I'm gonna go in with Dior Nude Air Foundation, and I'm going to be applying that with, what do you know, the Sigma F80 Kabuki Brush as always. I'm currently using the shade 030 in this foundation, and it actually is a pinch too light for me, but that's okay because I'm gonna go in with bronzer and I'm gonna warm up the skin and add some color. I would prefer my foundation to be a little bit too light over too dark any day of the week. Now I'm gonna be applying my under eye concealer, and I'm using the Urban Decay Naked Weightless Full Coverage Concealer. I think I just nailed it. I'm gonna just apply a little bit of it on the under eye area and then also on the lid as well. And then I'm gonna blend all of that out with a damp beauty blender. A tiny bit of this product goes a very long way. So as you see, I do not have to overuse it. And this is my favorite way to prime my eyes, is to just use concealer and then go over top of it with a powder. So I am using the Anastasia Banana Powder to set this entire area. That's my favorite way to prime. And I am using the Morphe M510 brush for this. I really like it because it's kind of tapered and precise, and I really like it for that area. Now I'm going to go in with the Chanel Cream Bronzer. I should have done this before I set my under eye area. I never recommend using any creams after powders, but I wasn't feeling well, so I wasn't really with it that day, so I forgot. But if you're doing this on your own, do the cream first and then set the under eye area. So I am using the Sigma F82, which is an angled kabuki brush, to apply this all over the cheekbones, the forehead, the temples, the chin. I'm just kind of bronzing, not contouring. Now I'm going in with Makeup Geek Peach Smoothie Eyeshadow, and I'm using a Sigma E40 brush to blend this back and forth in windshield wiper motions in my crease. Like I've said before, Peach Smoothie is my absolute favorite number one eyeshadow of all time. I basically can't do any makeup look without it. It's just perfect for a nice transition shade. Now I'm grabbing Makeup Geek Cupcake. On that exact same brush, I'm going to dust this right underneath that color, back and forth in windshield wiper motions from inner corner to outer corner, and then I will blend it upward. As that product kind of disappears from my brush, I will start going up like you see right now, just to make sure that everything is blended together and we have no harsh lines. Now I'm gonna go in with Makeup Geek Latte. This is kind of a reddish medium brown color, and using a more precise brush, this is the E25 from Sigma, I'm gonna put that lower in my crease area. So as you can see, I am no longer kind of blending upward like I did with the other colors. I'm kind of blending onward onto the eyelid, if that makes sense, as you can see right here. Then I'll go back with the Sigma E40 and blend everything out once again with absolutely no additional product on that brush. Now I'm taking Makeup Geek Chickadee. This is an oldie but a goodie. This has been one of my favorites forever. And with just a touch of that, I'm gonna put it in that upper crease as well. A lot of people are fearful of this color because it's orange and it can look crazy, but if you use just a touch of it, it adds such a beautiful glow. Now I'm going in with Makeup Geek Foiled Eyeshadow. This is in the Spotlight. This is one of my absolute favorite shadows ever. It is so beautiful. It is such a gorgeous beaming highlight shade for the lid. I am using a MAC 242 brush, which is just a flat shader brush, to apply that all over the lid. You can use your finger for this product. That works really well. What's great about these is you get no fallout, which is like my favorite part. So once I put that generously all over the lid, I will go back with the Sigma E25 and just kind of go over the edges. That way there's not a distinct harsh line to where this shadow starts. Then I'm gonna fill in my eyebrows. I'm using Anastasia Brow Wiz in the shade Taupe. I'm gonna skip through this really quickly though, because it's not so fun to watch, in my opinion. Now I'm going in with MAC Embark. I love Embark. This is one of my colors that I just have to have from MAC. It is a go-to color for me. It's a super dark, rich, kind of purpley brown. And using an E15 from Sigma, I'm going to just press that really tightly on my lower lash line. Not too generously because I don't want it to be too dark and smoky. Then taking any pencil brush and a little bit of that same latte color that I used on my upper lid, I'm going to just blend that out, making the goofiest face of all time. Now I'm going to go in with Mango Tango. This is another shade from Makeup Geek. Such a pretty kind of orangey pink. I love this color. And I'm just going to put a little dab of it on that lower lash line as well, just to give some more dimension. Now I'm going in with a creamy ivory eyeliner, and I'm going to line my waterline to really open up my eyes and make them look very fresh and springy. I will list the one that I use in the description bar down below. Now I'm applying mascara, so I am prepping my eyes for lashes. We're gonna be going in with my absolute favorite, which are Wispy Sweet Nothings by Velour Lashes. I love these because they look beautiful with or without eyeliner. They're not too over the top for my face and too dramatic, but yet they're still super girly and they make a statement. Now I'm gonna go in with Makeup Geek Blush. Man, it's a Makeup Geek day. I'm gonna be mixing Rendezvous and Spellbound to make a really kind of purpley pastel pinky cheek. I have been loving this color of cheek recently for spring. It's just so girly and dainty and super feminine. Now I'm going to be doing something that is so unnecessary, and I'm going to be using two separate highlighters. These are both by Becca, and we are going in with Opal and Moonstone, and I'm mixing those two together just because I own them both and they are absolutely gorgeous when combined. So I am using the Morphe M501 brush to place this all over the tops of my cheekbones, my cupid bow, a dot on my chin, and then I'm also going to use these shades to highlight the brow bone as well. I am again using the MAC 242 brush to highlight the brow. Now I'm going to go in, of course, with mascara. This is MAC Giga Black Lash. This is my favorite lower lash mascara. I know it seems high maintenance to have a favorite lower lash mascara, but I do. Now I'm going to go in with ColourPop Lippy Stick in the shade Westie, a beautiful baby pink, and I'm going to top that off with a NARS gloss in the shade Glow Pink, which is coming very soon in their spring collection. So that is a wrap on this fresh springy makeup look. I hope that you guys enjoy. Thanks so much for watching. As always, I love you, and I'll see you soon. Bye guys. Bad bitches, I could see your halo.